As you know, we have been studying about the electronic structure of molecules. In our earlier modules, we discussed about the molecular orbital treatment of the electronic structure of molecules. In this module, we will study another very important approach towards electronic structure of molecules, and that is the valence bond treatment. Now you already know why do we need these two approaches to study the electronic structure of molecules. As you know that in quantum mechanics, the first step is always to write the Schrödinger equation. And in the case of molecules, Schrödinger equation cannot be solved exactly because of the presence of the multi-electron system and because of the electron repulsion terms which are part of the Hamiltonian. This is the term which creates problems in the solution of the electronic Schrödinger equation. So, if Schrödinger equation cannot be solved exactly, what should we do? We follow two routes, two approaches. One was the molecular orbital treatment, which was a treatment in which we constructed a trial wave function and then applied variation theorem to solve the electronic Schrödinger equation. Today we will be studying about the valence bond treatment. This is another approach to construct an approximate or a trial wave function for a molecule. We will see how this wave function is constructed and then using variation theorem how one can solve and get some information about the electronic structure of molecules. I would like to mention here that the valence bond theory was the first quantum mechanical treatment which accounted for chemical bonding. This treatment was given by Hitler and London in 1927. And it was subsequently modified by Slater and Pauling in 1930s. It is therefore also sometimes known as Hitler-London-Slater-Pauling theory. Valence bond theory you must have read qualitatively at school level, at even at undergraduate level, and it's basically treats covalent bond as a shared pair of electrons, and that is basically the concept to which we all are used to. Now let's first of all discuss what are the important postulates of the valence bond theory. The first is that according to this theory, a valence bond is formed between two different atoms when the atomic orbitals of these two atoms, each containing one unpaired electron, they overlap. So, overlapping is the first condition for the valence bond to form. Once this overlapping takes place, the resulting bond is formed between the two atoms. And as a result of this overlapping, the electron density between the two bonded atoms increases due to overlapping. And this is something which is responsible for bringing stability to the molecule. We all know that covalent bonds are directional. And how do they get the direction? Because the direction of the covalent bond is along the region of the overlapping of the atomic orbitals. So covalent bond becomes directional, and its direction is along the region in which the two atomic orbitals overlap. So these are some of the fundamental postulates of valence bond theory. Now ultimately the question is, how do we construct an approximate wave function in the valence bond treatment to have a detailed study of the electronic structure of the molecules? Now the simplest molecule which can be studied using valence bond treatment is hydrogen molecule. If you recall, in the case of MOT, that means the molecular orbital treatment, we first studied hydrogen molecule ion and then hydrogen molecule. However, hydrogen molecule ion H2+ cannot be studied by valence bond treatment. Why? Because it just contains one electron, and that is not in accordance with the valence bond treatment. There we must have two atoms, then each atom must have one unpaired electron, and then these two atomic orbitals containing those electrons must overlap to form a bond. Therefore, the simplest system which can be studied using valence bond treatment is hydrogen molecule. Now let us look again at hydrogen molecule. Hydrogen molecule, as you know, contains two nuclei and two electrons. As it has been shown here, the two nuclei, that means the two hydrogen nuclei, are labeled as A and B, and the corresponding two electrons as 1 and 2. The distance between the two electrons is denoted by R12, whereas the distance between the two nuclei is denoted by capital R. R1A, as you can see in this diagram, is the distance between electron 1 and nucleus A, whereas R1B is the distance between electron 1 and nucleus B. Similarly, R2B is the distance between electron 2 and nucleus B, and R2A is the distance between electron 2 and the nucleus A. Since it contains two nuclei and two electrons, therefore the total number of terms in the Hamiltonian of hydrogen molecule will be as it has been shown here, and we have already talked about the formula for this. The total number of terms will be 10, and therefore the Hamiltonian for hydrogen molecule can be written as shown here. H cap is equal to minus H square upon 8 pi square mp. Mp is here the mass of the nucleus. And then del A square minus H square upon 8 pi square mp del B square. Here del B basically represents the Laplacian operator for the nucleus B. Then we have the kinetic energy terms for the two electrons. First is minus H square upon 8 pi square m e del 1 square, and the second is minus H square upon 8 pi square m e del 2 square. So these first four are the kinetic energy terms. Then we have plus E square upon 4 pi epsilon 0 r. This is the term which represents the repulsion between the two nuclei. And then we have the term minus E square upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R1A, which represents the attraction between nucleus A and electron 1. And then we have another term minus E square upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R1B, which represents the attraction between electron 1 and the nucleus B. Similarly, for electron 2, we have one attraction term which is minus E square upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R2A, and for other term for electron 2 would be minus E square upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R2B. And lastly, we have the electron-electron repulsion term, and that is, because it is a repulsion term, here it is positive, plus E square upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R12. So you can see here that there are 10 terms in the Hamiltonian of hydrogen molecule. Now we apply Born-Oppenheimer approximation, which we have already studied earlier. That means we can consider the nuclei to be fixed, and therefore nuclear kinetic energy terms, they can be neglected. Because, you know, the mass of the nucleus is much, much larger than the mass of the electron. And once we do that, the first two terms in the above Hamiltonian, they can be neglected. And therefore, we have electronic Hamiltonian HE cap, which is equal to minus H square upon 8 pi square ME del 1 square minus H square upon 8 pi square ME del 2 square. And then again, we have the four electron nucleus attraction terms, and then one term which is electron-electron repulsion term, and the last term which we have already discussed above, that is the nuclear-nuclear repulsion term. And therefore, if you can see, this electronic Hamiltonian can be written as HE cap equals HA1. That means this takes electron 1 with nucleus A. That means its kinetic energy term plus its attraction term. And then HB2, that means electron 2 with the nucleus B. Again, it takes its kinetic energy term and its attraction term to the nucleus B. And then the remaining terms are put in H prime cap. So this becomes our electronic Hamiltonian. After having discussed Hamiltonian and the corresponding electronic Hamiltonian, let's now try to construct the wave function for hydrogen molecule using valence bond theory. Since hydrogen molecule has two nuclei and two electrons, there are two possibilities. One possibility is that if the two atoms are very widely spaced, they are quite distant from each other, so that there is no interaction between them, then the electronic wave function for the system can be written as psi VB equals psi HA1. That means electron 1 is with the nucleus A and electron 2 is with the nucleus B, and there is no interaction between the two nuclei. For such a system, the total energy will be the sum of the energies of the two separate atoms, and that will be equal to E totals equals E HA1 plus E HB2. Now that was one possibility, but then there is another possibility which can be that if the atoms are close, it may not be possible to distinguish whether electron 1 or electron 2 is on atom A or B. So both possibilities can exist. That means electron 2 can also be around nucleus A and electron 1 can also be around nucleus B. Therefore, in such a state, the wave function for the molecule can be constructed by taking linear combination of both possibilities. That means psi valence bond is, here you can see that the psi valence bond is equal to psi HA1 psi HB2. This is the first possibility which we have already discussed. But plus psi HA2 psi HB1. Now the second possibility is where electron 2 is around nucleus A and electron 1 is around nucleus B. Therefore, we are taking the linear combination of both the possibilities. And therefore, it can be written in a general form, psi valence bond is equal to C1 psi 1 plus C2 psi 2. But you must have noticed that both these possibilities and their linear combination, they represent covalent structures. Because one electron is on atom 1 and the other electron is on the second atom. So they are basically representing covalent structures. But one can say that there is also a possibility which ultimately will lead to the ionic structures, that it is quite possible that both electrons 1 and 2, they are simultaneously on atom A. And at the same time, there is another possibility that both these electrons 1 and 2 are on the nucleus B. So these two will account for ionic structures. And if we take that also into account, then our psi ionic will become, as you can see here, that's equal to psi HA1, psi HA2. It means both electrons are on nucleus A, plus psi HB1, psi HB2. That means both electrons are on the nucleus B. So, with this background, one can very well understand that there are in fact four possibilities. Two possibilities which we discussed about the covalent structures, and then there are two possibilities which account for ionic structure. Therefore, the total wave function in valence bond treatment becomes psi VB is equal to psi covalent plus psi ionic, and that is psi HA1, psi HB2 plus psi HA2, psi HB1. These two represent covalent terms, plus psi HA1, psi HA2 plus psi HB1, psi HB2. These represent two ionic terms. So this becomes our total wave function. Once we have constructed the wave function, the next step, as you all know, what we have done in the case of molecular orbital treatment as well, one has to calculate the total energy of the hydrogen molecule. And this can be calculated using variation theorem, and this is given by the expression Ea equals integral psi valence bond He cap psi valence band d tau divided by psi valence bond psi VB valence bond d tau. That means basically this is the expression which we need to solve for hydrogen molecule to calculate the approximate energy of hydrogen molecule in the valence bond treatment. Now, how this expression is to be solved, how this energy is to be calculated, and what are the various terms which we get through the solution, these are the things which we will take up in our next module. So in this module, you have seen that we have discussed about the valence bond treatment for the electronic structure of molecules. As we said, this is the first quantum mechanical treatment to account for chemical bonding in molecules. It was first introduced by Hitler and London, and then subsequently modified by Slater and Pauling in 1930s. Valence bond treatment draws on the concept of a valence bond as a shared pair of electrons. Valence bond treatment for hydrogen molecule considers the total wave function for the molecule as a combination of psi valence bond and psi ionic, and then using this and using variation theorem, one can calculate the total energy, and this derivation of the total energy will be done in our next module.